69 and sub-varsity level. And then the girls basketball, and I started the program in 73.
Well, you're the very first girls coach then.
Yeah.
Okay, sounds good. Well, what did you think of tonight's ceremony?
Oh, I enjoyed it. I bring back so many memories, and you see all the coaches that you've worked with. It really stirs up the emotions.
Right. And so now being in government, you're kind of seeing progress in action here, saying goodbye to this place and into the new place. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, it's going to be hard to say goodbye to this place. This place will always be home. But it's nice to see the new building. Walked through part of it about a week ago. So that part was nice, but this will still be home. I spent 35 years of my life in this building, so this will always be home.
So you think eventually they should name that the Phil Jackson Gym or maybe the Pat Hattelstad Gym?
No, I would not. But I would think that they could transfer that name. I don't know why they wouldn't. He gave it a lot. We got a lot of publicity from him. He was very special, very gracious. He came back when we dedicated the facility. So maybe we could bring him back again. But maybe. I think they should do that.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, Coach.
You bet. Anytime. You bet.
Yes. Phil was a fun guy. We coached baseball together for our dean office, and we'd play in the driveway at home against each other. And my stepbrother was a really good athlete at the time and went to University of Minnesota when Phil went to UND, Buddy Carlson. And we just had a good time together. We were always really good person.